All right, it is Thursday. I see how casual we are in commercial break. We'll talk about things. I'll button up and I'll do it the proper way. We're going to talk with Dr. Britt Zimmerman, who's here from New Hanover Regional Medical Center. We were talking about kidney stones, and I had said, full disclosure, I've had them. Our director, Josh, you're back, I'm assuming, because I see Kevin right now. So the guy that's behind the controls of this show, I guess I'm breaking HIPAA laws now. Josh, also, so it's, I know firsthand, I've seen Josh, we've talked about this. It's awful if you've never had these.
It is the most common.
Welcome, by the way.
Thank you. It's the most common thing that keeps us as urologists up at nighttime. I was on call this weekend, had cases Friday, Saturday, Sunday, also Tuesday night at midnight, and then had to be in Southport yesterday early and two cases yesterday. So, and then my first case in an hour is going to be another kidney stone.
For those who are fortunate enough to not have this, and those of us who have, break down what it is we have dealt with internally, that it, when you hear numbers, they're so small, yet so painful.
Well, on the average size stone is about 4 or 5 millimeters. That's when we start having difficulty passing them, about 25 millimeters to be an inch. So you have something that could be very, very small. But most of the time patients come in and they just can't get comfortable, or they feel like they need to urinate. But
this guy, yeah,
you know, I had a lady a couple days ago that came in and just couldn't get comfortable. They actually had to transfer from an outside hospital, and her kidney stone was only about 3 millimeters. And we were concerned that she was getting very, very sick. And on Friday night, my lady that I had, you know, came in near death. And it's one of those things where if you upset the system and you're not able to drain your kidneys, your body lets you know about it.
Yeah. Calcium, is that the consensus that that's what the buildup is of these very small crystals?
So calcium oxalate's the most common stone, and we see that usually in diet. Here in North Carolina, a lot of people drink tea and a lot of sun drop, but also just dehydration. And most of us are now kind of drinking more sodas and not drinking enough water, and that's usually what precipitates the stone.
Yeah, and I know, and again, I will only speak firsthand knowledge for myself, that was one of the things when I was there. You know, I was asked right away, are you drinking enough? And I would say, well, when I'm at work in the morning, I don't drink coffee, I will have soda, but the predominance of my day is water. And then I was told to greatly increase that.
Yes.
What are the benefits there of it being really a flushing of your system if there is that blockage to begin with?
So the idea is that we try to get the patients unblocked. And when we kind of get you to the point where you're stone free, we say we want you to urinate at least 2 liters a day. Mm-hmm. That's a considerable amount. Most people can drink 2 liters a day, but actually to void or, you know, 2 liters a day is a substantial challenge.
Task, yeah.
Yes, because most of the time people are busy with their lives and they can't afford to run to the bathroom all the time. But I also have some patients where I work with my nephrology colleagues when we look to see if there's things that we can change in our diet, or they actually have metabolic problems for which we give them medicines for.
Yeah, it's something, you know, if you have this, you'll know that the discomfort, the feeling like you have to pee and you can't, it's awful. And I will say, again, firsthand knowledge, don't wait. I called 911. I got myself to a hospital to where I could be taken care of. I say this every week. Don't call me. I can't come to your house and help you. Don't call me. Don't call your physician. Call 911. Get it taken care of as soon as possible. That's the first time I've ever heard possible death linked to this.
Yes.
That's eye-opening to me. I have my little peek up in my desk over there at the screen to monitor myself.
We are here for you.
I appreciate it. Doctor, thank you for the time.
Thank